Hey everyone, have you ever wondered why we sometimes have a February 29th? That, my friends, is the mystery of the leap year. Now you may be asking, what on earth is a leap year? Well, let me spill the beans. A leap year is a year that gets an extra day, February 29th, tacked onto it. But why do we need this extra day? It's all about keeping time in tune with our planet's dance around the sun. You see, it technically takes the Earth about 365 days and 6 hours to complete a full orbit. That's not a neat 365 days, is it? So, to prevent our calendar from slipping out of step with the seasons, we add an extra day, February 29th, roughly every 4 years, and hence the mystery of the leap year is solved, at least for now. Now, we don't just add an extra day every 4 years willy-nilly. There are specific rules to follow. So, what's the magic formula for a leap year? Let's break it down. Rule number 1, the year must be divisible by 4. Easy enough, right? But hold on, it gets a bit trickier. Rule number 2, if the year is divisible by 100, it's not a leap year. Yes, you heard right. So the year 1900, although divisible by 4, was not a leap year because it's also divisible by 100. But wait, there's a twist. Here comes rule number 3. If the year is divisible by 400, then it is a leap year. So the year 2000, while divisible by both 4 and 100, was indeed a leap year because it's also divisible by 400. So remember, every 4 years, unless the year is divisible by 100 but not 400, got it? Before we wrap up, here are some fun leap year facts you might not know. Did you know that those lucky enough to be born on February 29th have a special name? They're called leaplings. Quite a unique club to be part of, isn't it? Now, let's talk about love and leap years. In some cultures, it's believed to be lucky to tie the knot in a leap year. So, if you're planning a wedding, maybe hold off until the next leap rolls around for that extra sprinkle of good fortune. And here's a nugget for the trivia buffs. Remember the year 2000? That was indeed a leap year because even though it's divisible by 100, it also checks the box for being divisible by 400. So, there you have it. The mystery of the leap year solved. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more fun science facts.